'Twas a fine upstanding bantam cock, so brisk and stiff and spry, with a springy step and a jaunty plume and a purple first look in his eye. In his little black blinking eye he had. I took him to the coop, introduced him to his 17 wide-eyed hens. He tupped and he tupped till there were no tups, and he bowed from the waist to them all, and he upped and he tupped them all again, he did. And then upon the peace of me ducks and geese he rudely did intrude, with glazed eyes and open mouth they took it all with fortitude, and a little bit of gratitude they did. He tupped my giggling guinea fowl and turned his attentions upon my 20 hysterical turkeys and a visiting migrant swan. My bantam thundered on, he did. He ravished my fantail pigeon den, my lily-white columbine, and while I was locking up my budgerigar, he took my parrot from behind. She was sitting on my shoulder at the time she was. Then all of a sudden with a gasp and a gulp he clapped his hands to his head, fell flat on his back with his toes in the air, my bantam cock lay dead, and the vultures circled overhead they did. What a champion brute, what a noble cock, what a way to live and to die. I was digging a grave to hide his bones from the hungry buzzards in the sky, when the bantam opened up a sly little eye. He gave me a wink and a sort of grin, the way that rapists do, he said, "You see them big daft buggers up there? They'll be down in a minute or two. They'll be down in a minute or two."